It's crazy how your heart just has a mind of its own. Yeah, yeah. Like when a smile that makes the choice on its own. Well, the funny thing about this heart of mine, it knows what it wants. But see, the crazy thing is, my mind tries to deny it. But girl, I can't fight what I know. I know. I never knew my heart could dance. Hey, hey, yeah, listen.
You with our kids. Yeah. You with,
your auntie used to have her hair like that.
Her dress.
Oh. Nobody stop laying by her dress.
Uh-oh, kids crying.
I'm McNeil. I promise to love you. I promise to cherish you. I promise to spend the rest of my life with you. I've been waiting on this moment. We finally got here. And I want you to know that I love you. Amen.
Amen.
Sarah, I want you to look McNeil, and this is just some charm that the Lord has placed on me to place in their spirit. Amen. Sarah, I want you to look your husband in his eyes, your husband-to-be in his eyes, and I want you to repeat after me. McNeil.
McNeil.
You're my prince.
You're my prince.
I finally found you.
I finally found you.
You've been my soulmate.
You've been my best friend.
You've been my best friend. And I am so happy we're at this point.
I'm so happy we are at this point.
And you are the love of my life. Amen. Now I want you both, I charge both of you all, to look at me and say, I am ready.
I am ready.
Both of you all together. I am ready.
I am ready.
To take this charge.
Take this charge.
In front of all these witnesses.
In front of all these witnesses.
That I love this person's hand that I hold.
That I love this person's hand that I hold.
And I'm going to cherish this person.
And I'm going to cherish this person.
Neil, I would like for you to close up with saying, Sarah, I'm going to be your covering from this point on. Sarah, I want you to tell Neil, I represent your name from this point on.
I represent your name from this point on.
And I love you.
And I love you.
Neil. We do promise to love and cherish in sickness and in health, for richer, for poor, for better, for worse, forsaking all others, keep thee only unto ourselves. As long as people love. And the rest of this coming. I now pronounce Mr. and Mrs. McNeil Dowden.
because she was hollering up at my window and wanted to fight McNeil. And I told her she's not going to get me put out of my apartment. And after we had to talk, she never did it again. I told her if she wanted to beat McNeil, beat him out on the sidewalk. So ever since then, we have been, she has been like a daughter to me. I have all these sons, and I have one daughter, and I have another daughter, and soon to have another one. So I just want to say I love her with all my heart. She has been nothing but a blessing to me, and I love my son to death too. And I just wanted to let her know how much I love her.
He's been in my life since I was 5, and me and him had our own ups and downs because we did not like each other.
What?
We hated each other. But that never changed the way that he loved my mom and was there for her. And over the years, we grew tighter and closer. We got a bond now. We're inseparable. My kids, that's his granddad. And my mom, that's my best friend, my road dog. You know, she's been waiting for this day since, I don't know. He was surprised when he actually proposed to her and stuff like that. So I'm just happy that this happened for them. They came a long way. They've been through so much. So I wish them nothing but happiness and blessings.
I'm very proud of you, sus, for the accomplishments you made throughout your life so far. You had my first niece, Shaquana, at a young age, but in spite of that, you graduated from high school a year earlier, showing that you were a determined parent. That was your first accomplishment. From there, you departed home to start your family by branching off on your own, which was your second accomplishment. I guess after having Shaquana, you decided you liked kids, so you went to college or early childhood. Graduated, that was your third accomplishment. Then you had my second niece, which is Santara. Went to college again to up your degree. Graduated, and had my third niece, Sapira. Now you're a first grade teacher, and been teaching for 10 years. And this is just to say, it didn't weaken your spirit. It actually strengthened your spirit with the help of God. Brother-in-law, I want to thank you for taking the step of asking my sister to be your wife. You're not individuals anymore. You're a pair, now one whole. You both raised my nieces, which are y'all BAPs, beautiful black princesses, to be mature and beautiful young ladies. May God bless your unity according to his plans today. And today is your new chapter, which begins once upon an hour.
Sarah, I knew it was coming sooner or later, just like we all did.
Thank you guys, make a beautiful couple. And, you know, hopefully y'all remain together for a long time.
To go fight one of the girls over McNeil. I was going to fight her too.